Hey, Stephen, how's it going?
Hey, Saraj, not bad.
Do you mind if I ask you 67 questions?
Sure.
All right, let's do this. What is the culture like at Salesforce?
The culture is great. It's a real emphasis on research and really, I guess, advancing AI.
What excites you the most about machine learning?
I think it's the capability for people to do stuff that no one had really been able to do before without like an entire workforce of people.
What is something you miss about where you grew up?
Okay, one thing about Australia's eucalyptus leaves, they are beautiful and they smell so nice. Eucalyptus trees are everywhere and luckily we have a few of them in California.
What time do you wake up?
I wake up, more like 10 a.m.
What was it like being a master's student at Harvard?
It was one of the most stressful but truly pleasurable experiences of my life. I learned so much.
What website do you absolutely love to spend time on?
I would have to say Twitter is my main vice, and also virtue.
Favorite machine learning paper of 2017?
Ooh, mixture of softmaxes.
If you could meet one person, who would it be?
Shannon from Entropy.
Your last AI startup got acquired by Salesforce. Mm-hmm. How did you celebrate?
Well, the whole team went out and had drinks at one of the nearby bars, so pretty normal.
What's it like doing research as a full-time job?
As a full-time job, it's amazing because you actually get to hone in on the exact problem that you're interested in and just stay there and keep working at it.
Bravest thing you've ever done?
Probably move to the US, away from friends and family.
What is one thing that scares you?
I would say heights, honestly. They're something that I don't think I'm ever going to be able to work past.
Favorite movie?
Oh, Inception.
Do you play any instruments?
I actually play piano and trombone and guitar.
What's more interesting, physics or neuroscience?
Physics only because we can understand it better at the moment.
Best present you've ever received?
When I was like, I think 9 or 10, my parents actually gave me a computer, but they sat it in the middle of the corridor and I didn't even realize it until I got to the room.
What is something you do to relax?
Best thing is usually television shows or movies with friends.
What is something surprising about you?
I am probably one of the pickiest eaters you'll ever meet, and chicken nuggets and frozen Coke are basically my life.
Do you prefer cats or dogs?
Horses.
What's a machine learning model that doesn't get enough attention?
I think starting with like the simplest baseline models is the best way to go. So just stick with multi-layer perceptrons for the starting point.
What's your favorite operating system?
I gotta say Linux.
Do you play any sports?
Not really, no.
Most adventurous thing you've ever done?
A multi-day hike through the Australian outback.
What's one source you use to stay up to date in machine learning?
Honestly, it's Twitter again. Like, the people you find there is just amazing.
Programming language of choice for machine learning?
Python.
Favorite professor?
Dr. James Curran from the University of Sydney, Australia.
Why do you think programming is fun?
I think programming, it enables you to do some completely and utterly tremendous things that, again, you'd never be able to do yourself. You can control a machine that can run billions of calculations a second.
What's the most amazing thing in the world?
Human society, because I don't see where the end point is for it.
Favorite comfort food?
Chicken nuggets.
Name one person you really admire.
One of my colleagues, James Bradbury.
What was your first program?
First program, it was a Hello World app that literally just read in my name and then spat it out back at me.
Last person you talked to on the phone?
Brad Nehmeyer from Nvidia.
You get an all expenses paid trip to one country. Where do you go?
Back home to Australia.
Would you live on Mars?
Yes.
What is one thing you can't live without?
Unfortunately, my laptop.
What is one skill you wish you had?
I honestly don't know.
What is the last thing you do before bed?
Okay, so I actually play the same set of four songs from a soundtrack every night from Ender's Game.
What text editor do you use?
Vim.
What open source library do you really like?
PyTorch is beautiful.
What was a hard problem you recently solved?
So most recently, language modeling.
What's the meaning of life?
Friends, family, and I guess science.
Who is one author you really like?
I love Isaac Asimov.
What is one thing that excites you?
That we're getting back into space.
Best advice you've ever received?
Just go for it, even if you have no clue what you're actually doing.
What is one piece of advice you'd give yourself 10 years ago?
Be less worried about making mistakes.
Do you spend more time on the internet or real life?
Internet, well and truly.
Do you have any pets?
Yes, if you count my parents. So it's three dogs, one cat, and three horses.
What's something you've learned in the past month?
How difficult audio is in terms of actually processing it with deep learning.
Do you like spicy food?
No, not at all.
What is a movie that made you cry?
Up, the beginning of.
If you ran the world, what is one law you'd enact immediately?
Oh, I'm going to try and stay away from being too controversial. A very soft universal income.
Is the singularity near?
Not near enough to worry about yet.
Who is one person you looked up to when you were in college?
Jonathan Kummerfeld, who basically taught me a good chunk of the programming I know.
What deep learning library do you use the most?
PyTorch.
If you were to start from scratch today, what is a learning resource you would use to learn machine learning?
Fast.ai by Jeremy Howard and Rachel Thomas.
What is one goal you have in the next 10 years?
In the next 10 years, I want us to be able to compose an entire orchestra without having to think about it.
Favorite subject in school when you were growing up?
Latin.
If you could be a superhero, who would it be?
There's something to be said about Iron Man for the fact that he had to develop everything himself.
What's your spirit animal?
Probably sloth. I'm kind of lazy.
What do you predict comes next after the deep learning hype?
Well, hopefully the deep learning hype doesn't die down, but I think everything connected devices.
Bitcoin or Ethereum?
Ethereum.
Did you delete your Facebook?
Nope.
Google Home or Amazon Alexa?
Neither. I don't want anything listening to me.
Do you prefer supervised or unsupervised learning?
Unsupervised.
Favorite conference you've ever been to?
Probably NIPS last year.
Awesome, Steven. Well, thanks for answering those questions.
Thanks, man.
All right, have a good one.